Today, we're going to talk about two expressions. The first one is freaking out from the movie Sing 2, which is not released yet, but will be sometime later this year. And the other is from a movie that came out last year, Sonic the Hedgehog. And that saying is bucket list. So I think we're going to start with freaking out, right?
Yeah. And I think they're both fun phrases. So I think this will be a fun conversation. Let me start presenting.
At the movies, where you learn American English heard at the movies. Do you think freaking me out means A, to be suddenly worried and fearful, or B, to become excited and very happy?
So what does everyone think the correct answer is?
A
for sure.
A, to be worried and fearful.
Did anyone think it was B?
Yes, I think it is B.
It is A, so he's saying like...
Play what? The rest of the...
Sorry. Okay,
well, and then we can talk about it.
Here we go.
Listen again. The answer is A. If something is freaking me out, I am suddenly worried and fearful. Johnny the gorilla is freaking out about preparing for the big show and training with the very forceful dance teacher. And that's English at the movies. I'm Dorothy Gundy.
I think it was something like to be happy more than being worried. That was why I thought it is the B.
Okay. Yes. Does anyone use that phrase, freaked out or freaking me out no, it's American. Yeah, it's if somebody is freaked out, it's not good. There's an element of surprise and worry and to be afraid or scared. There's an element of that too, right, Greg?
Yeah, also anxiety or nervousness. And I would say it's something that Americans say quite often. So when you're talking with your friends, for example, someone might say, this test I have tomorrow is freaking me out.
Yes. Yes. Or I'm freaked out because I have to study this test. I'm freaked out. Or usually, I was thinking about this. When I use freaked out, it's usually something that has to do with the surprise that I wasn't expecting and it wasn't good. So that usually, that's when I'll use this freaked me out. But if you guys can I hear some examples from is there any situation that you can tell us about of a situation, something that freaked you out?
For example, people are fighting in my country and that's freaked me out.
Yes, absolutely. This is the gentleman from Afghanistan, right?
Yes.
Yes, I understand that. And good luck. We're all thinking of you, I would say. The whole world is.
Thank you.
Yep.
That's... Yeah.
Oh, yes, thank you. That's happened to me last year because on March 2020, I had to travel in a travel with an excursion to Asia. And I know the situation by the pandemic on the world, but our agency made the travel. Made the travel, and as I asked the agency to renew the to remind the date, they don't want. Then I was fearful and fearful by that, because I did this travel, but I know the situation, the pandemic in the world, and the situation in the world. And then for me was a very freaking out that situation.
Yes. Yes.
Besides, I was afraid I can, I became ill in some place, what I can do, no? And to come back, if I come back in time, just in time, yes.
Good.
Was very freaking out in this situation, yes.
That's a good example. Thank you.
Thank you.
Yes, I've talked with other people who were traveling at the beginning of the travel bans, and they were also freaking out about coming home and possibly quarantining, and maybe the flights would have been canceled. So you were not alone in that. Alfredo.
Yeah, thank you, Dorothy. I have a question. Is there a way that you can apply this phrase in a positive, in a positive situation?
I think it's your tone. Like, if you were to say maybe like you went on a roller coaster and it took a really fast turn, and you could be like, "Oh, that freaked me out, but it was a lot of fun." Maybe in that situation, but it would still show that you were uncomfortable.
Okay.
Yeah, there's really no blanket. It is a blanket phrase that's, it's not good. You are uncomfortable. Yeah. So.
Okay, so I have an example. I have started a new job 2 weeks ago for a US for a company in US, and the selection process took so long. So the situation was really freaking me out during that time, because it took 2 months for them to decide.
That's a good example, because you didn't know what your future was going to be until you heard. Yes, that's a very good example.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. But I like the phrase. It sounds nice. Freaking me out.
I know. Freaking me out. Freaked me out. Yeah. It's the past tense, the present tense. Anybody else?
Thank you.
Is this a rising question that I want to ask? Is it the same way when we say, it makes me crazy, or drives me crazy, or it will be a turkey or something else? I just want to wonder that.
I think they're similar. Like, they're used quite similar.
Yeah. So it is kind of using your culture, freaking out. It is American culture, or?
Yeah, there was another question that I don't think we have time for. But I think Americans will show their like anxiety or maybe the like craziness they're feeling in a very open way. And so this is one way that we talk about it.
Okay, thank you.
You're welcome. David.
Oh, sorry. Yes, I think that I have an example for that. For example, I freaked out when I heard the news about the variants of the coronavirus.
Yeah.
Yes.
There's a lot to freak out over that.
That's a good example. Yep.
Rosalinda.
Thanks, Greg.
Welcome. What would you like to say?
Okay, that unfortunately my brother got sick because of the COVID, So this situation is truly freaking me out. I don't know how to handle the facts. Obviously, this is the first time that in my family, happened. So it's so difficult to know how to take care of him. So actually, I live with my father, but in this case, because of this situation, I'm here along with him. So it's really complicated to handle this. So that's why I really want to use the phrase, this situation is really freaking me out.
Yeah, I can imagine. Good luck with that.
But thank God everything is going all right. So okay. I hope that for the next week, everything will be under control. But right now it's been so complicated. But
yes,
this is part of life. So this is obviously because of the pandemic. That's why we need of ourselves as much as we can.
Right. Yes, and I think with something freaking me out, it, as I said before, there's an element of surprise in that. So you were not planning on your brother getting sick, and you suddenly have to deal with this, and it freaks you out. Yes.
Exactly, Dorothy, especially emotionally. It's like, oh my God, I can't believe it. It's when you receive the news, is the or you the doctor tell you, hey, you are sick of COVID. It's like I don't know how to describe it, but it's so hard to hear that you are positive. In this case, I think that one of the words that has a huge meaning right now is when you hear. It's like, oh, thank you so much, God. So this is probably one of the situations, the most difficult situations that we need to deal these days.
Yes, yes. Good luck with that.
Yes. F.
Thank you.
That's it, F. Shin.
Yes, that's a nice phrase. I never heard that before. And the example I can say is that when I'm gonna present at the college, it makes me very nervous because I'm going to present in front of the professor, and I think that's what's freaking me out.
Yes, because that makes you nervous and you have a lot of anxiety and it's freaking you out. That's a very good example.
Yeah. I have stress of not making mistake and to present everything with detail in a correct way.
That's right.
Well, good luck.
Yes.
I hope it goes well. Jason.
Hi. I think in Taiwan, the earthquake is very common. It's easy to meet an earthquake. So many international friends come to Taiwan. They will be freaking out of their first time of life. Yeah, because they could be met some earthquake. Yeah, it's very easy to occur. Yeah.
Yeah.
And do they freak you out?
No. Yeah. When I was a kid, I have some. The first time freaking me out, but for now, I'm used to it.
Right. That's how it is with people who live in California in the United States. They're used to the rumbles in the earth, and but people who visit are freaking out when it happens. Yes, very good. It's a good example.
That's a great example too of how to say someone else will be freaking out. So it shows that it's not just something that you can use to talk about yourself. You can use it to talk about other people too.
Yes, I would like to say it's a nice phrase, and this is a phrase freaked me out or freaking me out. It's let me to remember something about myself when I get on the plane. I remembered when the airplane flew or landed. It's freaked me out.
Right. That is.
That's common for most people.
Yeah. Yes. Especially, yes, the takeoffs and landings. Yes, especially.
I'm going to take two more responses, and then we'll move on to the next movie and phrase. So I think there'll be Nestor and Diego, and then we'll move on. So Nestor, would you like to talk?
Yeah, thank you for this occasion. We are in the beginning of a COVID-19 situation where schools were closing their doors. As a student, I was freaking out because I was thinking that I will drop down my studies. Yeah, that's all. Thank you.
That's a good example.
Yeah. And Diego?
Okay, Dorothy and Gregory, pretty strange. In Colombia, the quarantine is a froze like a maze. For example, I want to start a career, do a postpone, do a peak curve is postpone different projects. It's not only one, many people are affected this situation. Last year was unbalanced, but I think we're recovering little by little. In my case, what I think, I was wondering for you. COVID, when I start, there were crowds in the school, job, the lack of opportunities, and the economy is low. Suddenly, and nobody was expecting this situation. It is very common, freaking out.
Yes.
Yes, absolutely. And I think people still are, because no one is sure when this will end and how it will end, and will there be more variants? Will that force the schools and businesses to close again? We don't know. We can only take it a short amount of time at a time. And I think that does freak people out.
Yeah. And Diego brought up another way to use the word freak. He said freaky, which means strange. So if something is freaky, it's kind of strange or bizarre or like one of the two. That was another context word for the phrase.
Right.
I am going to show the next clip, and I won't ruin the answer this time. Promise.
This one is, what is it? Bucket list.
Yep. Let me just get it prepped.
The Hedgehog. Welcome to English at the Movies, where you learn American English heard at the movies. Sonic the Hedgehog is an action-adventure movie based on the video game series of the same name. It is about Sonic, who has the ability to run at supersonic speed to find his lost magical rings and escape the dangerous scientist Dr. Robotnik. He teams up with Tom. Listen for the words bucket list.
I've never sat in the bar stool before. So squishy. Oh, look at this. It spins. Whoa. I feel sick.
Damn fun.
I'm gonna check this off the old bucket list, huh? Big night for you. What's a bucket list?
What do you think a bucket list is? A list of successful things you have done, or B, a list of things you want to do or places you want to go before you die.
So what do you guys think?
B, obviously.
Okay. So a lot of B's, a couple A's. I'll keep playing it and we'll find out the answer.
Hi. Listen again.
Whoa. I feel sick.
Damn fun.
I'm gonna check this off the old bucket list, huh? Big night for you. What's a bucket list?
The answer is B. Listen as Tom explains the meaning to Sonic.
Bucket list is it's a list of things you want to do in your life before you kick the bucket.
Kick the bucket is an expression that means to die.
Uh-huh.
Sonic immediately starts making a list and doing some of the things he's always wanted to do. And that's English at the Movies.
So I was trying to figure out why bucket. So you have the bucket list, which is a list, like the story says, that people make of things they want to do in their life. And sometimes people make the list in their mind. Sometimes they actually write it on a piece of paper. And it means things you want to do before you kick the bucket. So why is bucket having to do with dying? I looked it up, and it's because of the way long, long time ago, there was a certain way that animals were slaughtered, and there was always a bucket involved. So that's why the word bucket is used in these expressions. So does anybody have a bucket list?
And before we start answering, I would like people who maybe didn't talk in the last set to give an answer if they want to practice. So I'll just let those people go first, and then we'll take people who have already talked. So anyone who hasn't talked yet. Monica, did you talk?
I don't think we heard from Monica.
Monica.
Hi, thank you. Well, I'm in my bucket list. There are two things. Because of COVID, I can smell anything and I can taste any food. So in my bucket list is as soon as possible, drink a delicious cup of coffee in the morning. And I hope so that is happening soon. It will happen soon. Thank you.
Yeah, it might take some time, but I read that you can retrain your taste buds and your smell receptors. Just by like smelling strong things and tasting strong things, it might come back.
Yes, I can smell anything and I can taste anything.
Oh, I'm sorry.
It's very sad.
Yeah. Well, I hope that comes back.
I do, yes.
Okay, thank you very much. I can say it is in my bucket list. After finishing the college this year, I want to travel around the world and I want to experience different foods and I want to see different countries. It's in my bucket list. That can be right?
Good. Any special country
USA. I really want to see USA, and I really love people in America.
Great. Good. Yeah. Well, good luck.
There's a lot to see, so maybe
thank you
choose the places first. Yeah. Because I think when you arrive, you'll be like, oh, it takes a while too to get around. But
it's a very large country.
Yeah.
And I really like this country. I love it. The culture, the people, the movies, the theater, all the things are great, I think.
Good.
Yeah.
Well, hopefully someday soon it will all be opened up. Yes.
Okay. Afshin.
Okay, thank you so much. I think this list includes a lot of things, but the first one which has priority over the others is, as our friend said, is going around the world. Especially my dreamy city is the New York, and I really like to visit that city and live there. This is the first priority in my bucket list.
Wow. Okay. Cool.
Yeah, I'd also love to live in New York City. That is on my bucket list as well. It is such a cool city. Jason.
If someday I am retirement, the first one bucket list is that I would like to go a trip around Taiwan the cycle by feet.
Oh. I'm
a marathon runner, so I would like to finish the long distance run for 1,400 kilometers around Taiwan cycle.
That sounds great.
So are you saying like by a bike or by walking?
By jogging.
Jogging, okay. Call that a hike, but hiking or a marathon? Yeah. But hiking isn't running, so.
Probably jogging.
Good.
Awesome. David.
Yes, in my bucket list, I have to visit other places and learn other language. For example, I think that I am very close to check off in my bucket list English, and then I want to learn other like Italian or Portuguese. But I have a question about the second expression. The second expression was keep the bucket.
Yes.
This expression is only used in informal contexts or is usually in other contexts?
I would say it's informal.
Informal, yes.
Yeah.
That's a good question. Yes, no one, you know, people should be respectful with death, as we always know. So if you say kick the bucket, it is informal. You're not talking about anything that is a shock or hurtful or so that's a good question. Mm-hmm. It is an informal expression.
Yeah, and I think if maybe someone had recently passed away, or if you know there's still some grief there, it's not something you would use with that person.
Right.
Ah, okay. Is it better only use this expression with my friends, not with other persons?
Yeah, in a maybe a lighter context, you know, just kind of a fun conversation. If it's, you know, a more emotional conversation, don't use it. I think that would be a little bit hurtful.
Thank you.
Muhammad.
Yeah, so it is the question that I want to hear from you, Dorothy or Greg. What place that you want to travel. I highly recommend if everything is clear and everything opened up, I want to recommend you to go to Bali. It's paradise of Indonesia. And for all of you guys.
Thank you. I would love to go to Bali. Absolutely. It's on my bucket list.
Yeah.
What about you, Craig?
Yeah, I have been thinking about it for a while. I love traveling. Like, there's almost nowhere in the world I wouldn't want to go. So for a while, I was kind of dreaming of doing like a world cruise. So you get to see all the countries, but then there's some, you know, ethical issues with that when it comes to pollution. So had to really think about that one. I think Asia is my next area, you know, that I'd like to go to. Indonesia, Japan, Korea, Taiwan, all sound like really interesting places. You know, Southeast Asia, India, just really seeing a lot of the area.
Yes, I remember one thing about the bucket list. When my kids were in school, I was busy with them. Right now, they are in the college. I see myself, I have a free time. I plan to have a bucket list to fill my time with some activities. Like, for example, reading in the library or volunteering in some centers, exercising, traveling.
Yeah.
And that's all.
Very good.
I think that shows, too, that a bucket list can be, you know, daily things that you want to do, or, you know, it doesn't have to be some, you know, big expensive thing. It can be, you know, just something you want to integrate into your life.
That's right.
Yeah.
That's good.
Alfredo.
Yes, I have to add an item in my bucket list, and it is for a Bali and other places to be less expensive. Before going there.
That's funny.
Yeah.
Thank you.
But by the way, is it correct to say that to add a wish, not exactly traveling to other places, but for example, deciding for something to be less expensive or something like that can be the bucket list?
No.
It's an action.
It's an action that you take, yeah, okay. That really affects mainly you and your family, not everybody else.
Okay, perfect. Thank you.
Yeah. And with the traveling, sometimes you have to wait for the currencies, you know, to be at a point where it is cheaper, because it might happen, you know. Your currency might get stronger and the other one might, you know, get weaker, and then it's cheaper.
Guys, let me suggest you something. If you have the chance to add in your bucket list to go to see the Northern Lights, believe me.
Have you seen them?
Yes. 2 years ago, I went to Fairbanks in Alaska. I love to do
it. I have always wanted to
Northern Lights.
Yeah.
Wonderful.
Yeah. We're talking about in my family doing a trip to Alaska. So that we also want to do that.
Yeah.
We just have a few minutes left. So if anyone has any final comments or maybe questions, it seems like these phrases were a bit, you know, unusual. So if you have any questions or final comments, this would be a good time. Shaw?
Yes, I want to ask a question. I have a question for you, Madam Dorothy Gundy. My question is that some of my students think that learning these phrases that we see at the movies, they are not useful. So they're sticking just in books. What's your opinion or what can you advise them? And can you say that learning these phrases can help them and they should think about movies and they should allocate some time to watch movies? Is it a good thing or not?
I would say that depends on your interest. If you want to learn English, this is kind of a fun way to learn. I don't think you need to take it very seriously. So if you just want to learn about phrases, for instance, freaking out, which is not used anywhere else in the world, it's just fun. You don't have to think too much about it. And as far as watching movies, you should if you're interested in them. If you're not interested in watching movies, then you shouldn't force yourself to do it. But if you are interested, it is a good way to learn English.
I would also say it would also matter what type of English you'd like to learn. So from a movie, it might be more conversational and it would help you, you know, maybe make friends and socialize with people in English. Whereas if you want to learn more academic or business English, it might not be as helpful. So something to consider.
But about English at the movies, it's meant to be fun, basically. It's so I know freaking out and kicking the bucket are not fun topics, but they're from movies and it's fun to watch. And you not only learn the phrase, but you learn, you know, how the English language sounds. And so I hope that people enjoy it. I hope that you, the audience, when you watch English at the movies, that you enjoy it.
Yes. I have a question about the first expression, freak out. I was wondering myself if it can be used in a passive voice. Freaked out. Is it possible?
The passive, like
voice,
like freaked out. I was freaked out.
For example, I was freaked out. Is it useful? Yeah.
Yes, I say it all the time. I was freaked out. You. Yes.
Yeah.
Okay. Thank you. Another question that I have, as I took the initiative of learning English, I see that I have some problems, especially in listening. When a native speaker is talking to me, I have difficulties to hear him or to catch him. I would like to have your point of view. In which way can I do in order to improve my listening skills? Yeah.
Right.
Did you catch me?
Yeah, so with VOA, we publish almost, I think, all of our pieces with audio. So if you find a news story on the website, you could listen to it, and that will really help.
But and they talk slowly.
Yeah.
So you can, and the words are there so you can understand. But I would say to you to start with something like that, where people speak slowly and you can read along. And as you become more familiar with the language, you can maybe watch some Netflix or some videos that speak a little faster. I think you have to take it slowly to go listen for a long time at slow speed and then slowly work your way up as you become more familiar. I think the more you listen, the more you will become familiar eventually.
So we're out of time. The recording will end now, but if you want to stay on, if you have any final questions, we can answer those. So we'll just let the recording end here.
Yes, and thank you for the people who are up at midnight and 1 o'clock in the morning for hanging in there.
And thank you, Dorothy, for joining us.
Oh, you're welcome.